Good evening. Tonight, I want you...
What a rude person!
Great. I like it.
I think it's one of the only remaining avenues we have for an unbiased opinion.
The whole family is always watching it.
I think it's marvellous.
Good evening. Richard Moorcroft with the Newcastle and Northern News for ABC Television. Newcastle people will be paying less for their gas from today. The Newcastle Gas Company has reduced its charges following the arrival of the natural gas pipeline from Sydney. Yeah. From today, the surcharge on gas bills imposed during the pipeline's construction last year will be lifted, bringing gas prices back to the July 1981 level. A gas company spokesman said...
Hello, welcome
the move
to Sydney.
..would effectively reduce gas bills. I like it much better this way. It's a very friendly place. Very happy to be here.
Just continuing on with this news, a gas company spokesman said the move would effectively reduce gas bills by about 20%. This is Geraldine Judd continuing on with the, what is it, Newcastle News, is it?
Newcastle and Northern, yes.
Newcastle and Northern, it goes to Tamar. Did he sound off road to the roof? Excuse me.
Would you actually want to see?
Yes,
look,
thank you.
Let me make room. Thank you. Here we are, this is much more comfortable.
Power charges were still being discussed. Power charges were still being discussed by the Shortland County Council up to a short time ago. The Council's Finance Committee, they don't know anything anyway. Dear Abby, met to discuss the recently announced rise in bulk charges announced by the State Electricity Committee.
As long as you keep it in focus. I don't give a stuff what you do with it, as long as it's in focus and on time.
Unfortunately, one of the greatest failings of my career, apart from staying with the ABC, is that I can't sing.
Can't read that. Breezer Station, about 40 kilometres south of Gunnedah, fronts the Mooki River and his five homes, as well as many other improvements.
A Canadian professor has appeared in London court where he denied spying for the Russians for the past 30 years. Earlier, a British woman diplomat was given a 9-month suspended sentence after she admitted passing confidential information to her Egyptian lover. This report from the NBC. Report remains top secret, I think. Excuse me. Yes? Sorry about that. The state government will make radical changes to motor registration and license fee renewals and costs. Introducing the bill in Parliament today, the Transport Minister, Mr. Crabb, said motor registration procedures would be streamlined and the cost of the registration process would be reflected by an increase in existing fees. Excuse me. Yes? All right. What page is that, please? Thank you very much indeed. Agnes Warren will be bringing us details on the story that I've just mentioned in a few moments. But meantime, we'll be able to have that later, shall we? Thank you very much indeed. Well, I'm sorry, we can't bring you that item at the moment, but there is a good chance that later on in this bulletin it will be included. Apologies. The solicitor, Mr. Ronald David Silverstein, Liberia's consul, was subpoenaed yesterday, just 3 weeks before the commission is due to present its final report. Lena Keneven. Yes, yes. Well, I'm going to have to apologize. Thank you very much indeed. I'm going to have to apologize to you once again. We are in a degree of difficulty, as no doubt you've gathered by now. And that item also from Lena Keneva we hope to be able to bring you a little later. But meantime, we press on with other items, with more apologies. Production of the Nomad aircraft is to stop by 1984. The Minister for Industry and Commerce, Sir Philip Lynch, said today the decision had nothing to do with changes to the defence programme. Here, hopefully, is Bram Alexander with the details. Well, The United Nations Secretary General, Mr. Perez de Cuellar, as we told you earlier, says he'll spend the next few days trying to reconcile the difference between Britain and Argentina over the peace plan for the Falkland Islands. Here's our BBC correspondent on the subject.
In Sydney, this is Justin Burke reporting.
Now, I think we're ready for that Lena Caniva report that we tried to bring you earlier. Just in case we are, I'm going to give you the introduction again. The Royal Commission into the Builders Labourers Federation has been unexpectedly reconvened following allegations today that a Melbourne solicitor was laundering union money.
Well, unfortunately for Jeff, it wasn't. Richard Moorcroft continuing from Sydney. Australia's only formally acknowledged cultural ambassador, Sir Les Patterson, has lent a rather unusual exhibit to a London museum.
The place was Madame Tussauds, the historic wax museum. And there to unveil the latest exhibit was one of Australia's best-known cultural ambassadors, Sir Les Patterson. According to his agent, Barry Humphreys, this distinguished former Minister for the Arts is now Emeritus Vice-Chancellor at the London School of Australian Studies. But academic life hasn't stopped him writing verse.
I stand here before my old media buddies as Dean of the School of Australian Studies. And it's as an academic I come to praise Madame Tossard, my artistic old chum. From the tip of your glad to the jewels on your glasses, you'll prove Australia's got culture up to our asses. So here she is for all to view. Eat your heart out, Danny LaRue. How about that, fellas? Not bad, eh?
Dame Edna Everidge may need no introduction, but some in Britain see extradition as the only answer to Sir Les. He and Dame Edna will be back in Australia shortly, if they can find an airline that'll carry them.
Please release me, let me go, for I don't love you anymore. Good on you, Australia. You've made it to Madame Tossard's House of Wax. No worries.
This is Mark Colvin at Madame Tussauds in London for ABC News.
The funeral of King Suboza of Swaziland was held today. None of his 100 wives would comment on the cause of his death.
The late king's favourite wife, the Endlovukazi, or the great she-elephant, now rules the country until the king's successor has been appointed. The king's family were all there, and that adds up to about 100 wives, 600 children, and many hundreds of grandchildren. Swaziland's Air Force staged a flypast with both of its airplanes. Mystery and secrecy shrouds the funeral rites, and much to everyone's amazement, the casket arrived with the late king's body propped up inside it.
A would-be balloonist has survived an unorthodox flight over Los Angeles.
Larry Walters had always dreamed of flying a balloon to a faraway place. So with help from a friend who taped these scenes, he rigged 42 weather balloons to a lawn chair and filled them with helium. Walters hoped to fly across the mountains to the Mojave Desert, staying in touch with a CB radio. Suddenly a cable broke and up he went with one emotion.
Fulfillment. I was on my way.
The first casualty, his glasses. They slipped overboard, leading to this radio transmission with his girlfriend.
Other glasses, I can see perfectly, don't worry. You copy, over.
I copy. Are you sure you're okay? There's trees up there. We can hear them. Are you okay?
I'm okay. I'm going through a thin fog layer, over. My altitude's 1,500 feet. See Marineland right now.
Hey, you can see Marineland. So you're heading toward, oh my God, you're going towards the ocean already.
Yeah.
Hey, everybody down here says to cut it and get down now. Cut your balloons and come down now. Everyone wants you down now.
The balloon reached 16,000 feet, spotted by two astonished airline pilots. But the craft wasn't moving, so after nearly 2 hours, Walters shot out some balloons with a BB gun and came down fast over Long Beach, the only time he was frightened.
All I saw were rooftops and power lines. I thought to myself, my God, this is it. You know, please God, you know, don't let me get fried.
Today, Walters said he has no intention of going ballooning again. His first priority now is to sell the rights to his story. David Burrington, NBC News, Los Angeles.
And that's all for this news. Now it's time for Home Sweet Home.
Dad, you're crying.
I'm not crying. I'm just very happy.
We're a family again.
Hey, come on, we all have a drink, huh?
I bought a bottle of champagne.
Here you go, Dad.
Anna, grazie. Hey, well, we're going to drink a toast here.
Who to?
Me.
Terrific.
Why are you in, so?
Because I'm the only one, huh? We're the best of family and the best of friends in the whole world!
Now, the problem, we had a lot of problems with the champagne. We've done it three times, and I tried to time it in such a way so that I could push the cork to the end of the dialogue, but it beat me. What could I do? It started to move up. So I don't know whether Jeff wants to do... He does want to do it again.
Oh, yes, we do the champagne again, I'm sorry.
We do the champagne again.
Yeah. Okay.
The ABC actually went to the expense of $18 to have four bottles during rehearsal. But sometimes they just start to move up. They've been in a bucket of hot water so that it comes out quickly. I don't know.
We're a family again.
Hey, come on. Are we all going to have a drink, huh?
I bought a bottle of champagne.
There you are, Dad.
Hey, grazie. You know something? We got to drink a toast.
Who to?
At me. Oh, grazie. Hey, come on. We're going to drink a toast, huh?
Who to?
To me.
Terrific.
Well, why are you in, so?
Because I... Come on, we're going to drink a toast now.
Who to?
Concentrating so much on the bloody bottle, I didn't forget my bloody lines. Oh, God, isn't this ridiculous? Okay. Right, here we go again. We're going to drink a toast now.
Who to?
To me.
Terrific.
Well, why you, Enzo?
Because I'm the only one that's got the best of family and the best of friends in the whole world.
Good morning, Ita and Di. Have you got a tip for us, Ita?
Morning, Kerry.
A tip? Oh, well, I don't think you can get past the favourite Kingston town, Sue.
Uh-huh.
Nice one.
Shut your mouth, Ita.
I thought that early in the morning.
Now, I thought we were mates.
Ita, it's Steve here. I wanted to ask you about some of the fashion...
Shit.
Where am I?
Don't be stupid. Be serious.
I'm throwing up.
Don't spit it, please.
Get your gear off.
Oh, rubbish.
It's true.
It's not true.
What about my underpants?
And it's really funny. At least that's what they tell me down at Promos. Watch it anyway.
Stop the fooling about.
Ah!
What a fucking boring story that was. I might say it's just manageable, mate. It's gonna work, right? So we're stand by now and cue.
You're watching Channel O28, Multicultural Television. Are you thinking of a career in television? Why not try the O28 Central Apparatus Room? Foreign orders a specialty. fully computer-controlled senior technical officer. Relaxed atmosphere. Friendly supervisor. Informal dress. State-of-the-art equipment. Come to where the action is, the O28 Central Apparatus Room. If you or somebody you know are having trouble receiving channel O, why don't you try UHF channel 28? Now, most modern television sets have a UHF tuner like this. Oh, poor.
Mouse, geh mal weiter.
Geh allein weiter. Ich scheiß.
Allein kann ich nicht weiter. Komm aus oder ich schieß.
Schieß du nur. Ich scheiß.
And so we've come to the end of the evening here on O28. Why don't you join us tomorrow when Susanka Kutina will be your host for the evening. One program I'll be looking forward to is the final part of the Italian series La Felicità, and that's on at 8:30 tomorrow night. That'll be followed by the final episode of a very popular Greek drama series called The Inheritors. But for now, it's good night. My name... fuck. My name...
Why we have Anzac Day?
No, I don't, Mrs, because I come from Great Britain.
Oh, right. Well, Anzac Day is a special day for remembering some people who fought in World War One.
What fellas are that, then?
The Anzacs. You know, the Australian New Zealand Army Corps.
Oh!
And they actually trained overseas together and fought one of their first battles at Gallipoli, which
where?
Is a place in Turkey. Gallipoli.
Gallipoli.
They call the place where they fought Anzac Cove now, just to remember them as well.
That's good, isn't it?
Yeah, it all happened a long time ago in 1915.
But still we remember.
Right, today, Anzac Day. Oh, shit!
yesterday.
Wasn't me, missus. Anybody got any paper?
Oh, another one bites the dust. My headache. Well, I have to really say, what headache?
New Tylenol from Johnson & Johnson & Johnson. Effective strength paracetamol. It's effective strength paracetamol. And Tylenol brand works fast on upsetting your stomach without upsetting your stomach.
My headache at the moment feels like a jackhammer's. The noise of a jackhammer's just pressing in on top of it. Unreal.
New Tylenol from Johnson & Johnson & Johnson. Effective strength headaches without upsetting your stomach.
Yeah, I'm normal now. Tylenol worked.
Thank God I'm gay, otherwise I'd be excited.
Welcome back to our early edition of Sports Scene. My biggest worry was, in fact, getting Pat Welsh here this morning. Pat, I thought you'd still be at Fantasia's at the Gabba. Sorry, mate, we'll record that again.
Another one bites the dust. The sprinklers have come on at BFL Park in the middle of the match.
They'll do anything to win a game. There's
big war coming on.
That looks terrific. It looks as though you're on the continent, doesn't it? Oh, look at that, spinning around beautifully.
Coming in so strongly, and in comes our blessed dog again. John Gilchrist to Cook. That's one for Brian Gibbs to chase. There's hardly any chance here. And still that pooch is in it. What a tackle. What a great tackle. But unfortunately, Chick Brody seems to have been hurt by that. Another one bites the
dust. Wendy, you two have had a great relationship as far as the doubles pairing is concerned. What do you put down the secret of that?
Well, I think, you know, we both play very good doubles, and we don't get down on one another when one's not playing well.
I see. Well, is that right? Well, you, really, Wendy, you don't know what you've been missing out on.
Oh, poo, what have you got on that bucket?
Shit.
Oh, what do you use that for?
Nothing, I use that one.
Oh, poo.
It's true that even the mildest pre-wash stain remover can shift some stains. But when it comes to grease and oil-based stains, the most common and difficult stains of all, independent tests prove nothing works better than Preen. Preen's superior formula works deep down to break up and dissolve the grease that locks them in. To really shift stains, Preen, the great stainer.
The fire is believed to have started in this brick preparation room where they make the loaves. Is that where they make up the loaves?
I think Redcliffe can win with two provisos. Firstly, shit, what are the two provisos?
On one map, we try and take you to places you normally wouldn't get to. This, in fact, is a giant Rolls-Royce engine off a Qantas jumbo jet. And in fact, very soon on one map, we'll be showing you lots of stories about Australia's own airlines. When you think about it, when you look at these engines, there's only one thing to say. Fuck, aren't they big?
Come on, Aussie, come on, come on. Come on, Aussie, come on, come on. Come on, Aussie, come on, come on. Come on, Aussie, come on.
Get set, we've got a surprise. Open your eyes, open wide and say, ah, comedy, ah, drama, ah, movies, ah, stars, ah, Channel 7, all the best. Look at us fly, open your eyes, open wide and say, ah, Channel 7, all Channel the best.
Yes. Makes you want to throw up, doesn't it?
Hear, hear, me too. You know, around here, it's terrible. If you're not married by your 21, it... fucking shit.
Don't be disgusting, darling.
Why don't you go and take it out on your patients?
I'm worried about Frank.
Oh, you think he's going to renege or something?
No, it's not that at all.
What is it, Mum?
Fucked if I know.
Oh, thanks, darling. Look, I'm going to be on the phone for the next hour so you can feed the animals.
Me? But I've been working all day.
Brendan, my blood is up. The country is the last bastion of male chauvinism.
<I'm sorry. laughs> Your blood is up.
My blood! I said my blood.
You said your blood is up.
I did not.
If my blood is up.
My blood is up.
Very sorry, Bruce.
I'll do a take two.
Thanks, darling. Now, look, I'm going to be on the phone for the next hour, so you can feed the animals.
Me? But I've been working all day.
Brendan, my blood is up. The country is the last bastion of male chauvinism. Well, the barricades are about to tumble.
Well, what about dinner?
You could...
Where does it end? Okay, I know. By the time we turn around, you'll be recording.
My pleasure to introduce a learned colleague and comrade in arms, Fatso.
Oh, Fatso. You dear, dear Fatso. Aren't you gorgeous?
Now, look.
Ow! Sorry.
You little shit.
Yeah, what's the next slide?
Sorry.
Ow!
It's only a $250 piece of sofa, but don't worry about it.
And action.
Ready?
Now, holding my breath.
Here I come then. Ta-da!
Ow!
I didn't know I had that effect.
You want to watch him there?
He's all right, he won't fall off.
Oh. Pat him.
You all right?
Did you break him yourself?
Yeah.
I thought so. He responds so well to you.
Oh, no. Ah, stomper, stomper.
I fell out of the bloody rock.
Nice and white, Stump.
Yeah.
No, but...
decorator's dream. Oh, there's so many opportunities for someone with imagination.
Everyone else feels sorry for me.
I'm envious. I could go berserk with the house that's in such a mess as this.
Just ignore them.
I can't.
And say hello. Morning.
Good morning.
Oh, they're bored. There's nothing going on in town. You and I have the big news.
Why don't they just go to a circus or the movies or something?
You're running well.
I've been doing it for 2 years.
What's it going to take me that long to feel the benefits? I feel terrible. Oh, shit.
I'll go pick up.
Max, you in there?
Yeah. Oh,
g'day,
Bob.
G'day. Fucking
thing. Ah, shove off. Come on, kids. Off that sacred ground.
Take two. Right. Did you hold focus, Marty?
Yeah, right, John. The poly was just in.
You rolling, mate?
Yeah. Okay, here we go.
Right. We're off.
Action.
Take your foot off the brake.
No. It takes a little bit of getting used to.
Oh, by the way, how is Fatso? Give you any trouble?
Not a bit. He's over there. Well, what did you expect me to do with him?
I mean, but a cage! A beautiful, free, wild creature like Fatso.
You open that up, and it's only because you're taking him home.
Through, seven, hey? Oh, shit.
Get set, we've got a surprise. Sit back, open your eyes. Open wide and say, ah, comedy, drama. Channel 7.
Along the three-quarter line, and they say the Parramatta Eels can't attack. They attack today. Glover scored a fine one, and then Roma. I can't work under these fucking conditions, really. I can't.
Weather now, here's Michael. No, it's not. Caught you, Michael.
Good morning.
Your turn.
I don't know if you can quite hear me at the moment, but getting the microphone together, putting it on. Good morning. It's a little bit cloudy and wet in some parts of the continent at the moment, particularly around Sydney.
I would say that it is now a fair forecast to say that we can expect 10% unemployment by the end of this financial year, that is next June.
One in every 14 or 15 people.
One in every 10.
One in every 10, yeah.
Just wish people in a position to influence public opinion would stick to subjects they have personal knowledge of and at the very least get their facts straight. I'm also angry that politicians can make noises like it wasn't our fault that the New South Wales electrical grid has run down. It's our predecessors. Talk about passing the buck. But then all politicians tend to treat us, the public, like retarded children, don't they? You know, governments at state and federal level in Australia have become gutless, and that's a fact.
Well, if you believe that, Rex, you're a bigger fool than than anybody thinks.
As the producer of the show, I wouldn't have it any other way. But he needs a little bit of a belt under the ear to get him motivated.
Rex can be a very lovable person.
Oh, it's too fucking late. I can barely see the bloody auto cue anyway with this stuffing light. Come on, let's just record the bloody thing and forget those. We'll do it the way we did it last year. I can't work with these primitive bloody conditions. Bloody handwritten, Christ knows. Come on, we'll be doing it live to air and fuck it up properly that way. It's the second fucking time I've done that. Shit, shit, shit.
We'll be back with more after this. No, we won't.
Sorry.
We've got 1 minute.
Oh, thanks, pal. Thanks a lot. Yeah, really nice to have a lot of notice for this show. Yes, this is a voice test. This is a voice test. I was... Could you please turn it... Oh, shit. You just messed up my monitor.
How come we've only got only Q on one camera?
It's me, boss.
Could you someone turn the monitor back to where it's supposed to be, please? Good evening. It now appears as if there's no hope. Right. Don't think I know what's coming next. A commercial break. We'll be back in just a few minutes' time. That important film by courtesy of NBN Newcastle, and in the studio to discuss it with us is... this is getting to be a bit of a farce. Sorry, take 100. That important film by courtesy... Thank you, everyone. Everyone, thank you. Are we finished? We'll be back with more news after this break.
Lord, what'd you do to your hair?
Why would you want to look like this?
It's a new fad. I like it. It's really great. And all you people out there, do it. It's really great. You need me to look funny, but it's great. You know, it's really great.
It's really great. Turn a boy into a chook. The northern New South Wales city of Grafton has planned a huge birthday party for this weekend. Pardon me. Pardon me. The northern New South Wales city of Grafton. This is impossible. Planned a birthday party to celebrate the 50th anniversary of its unique double-decker bridge. This is the first time this has happened to me. I've heard about it, but you don't believe it'll ever happen to you. The bridge was officially opened on July the 19th in 1932, was built at the same time as the Sydney Harbour Bridge. For 5 years, the whole nation followed the race between the two to be first finished, which Sydney won by only 3 days. Peter McKinnon.
Case is one of strength and cohesion. He told the jury there is only one possible. I will not be ridiculed to convict Lindy Chamberlain of murder, Mr. Barker says.
Okay.
After describing the Crown case as one of strength and cohesion. This is the Chamberlain trial. These people are about to be found guilty on a serious charge.
I was alone, confused, in a dull and lifeless scene. Then Suzanne gave me summer color, bold and bright for me. This goes with this, goes with this, goes with this, and this goes with that. This goes with this, and this goes with that, and Suzanne. Let summer come alive with color. This goes with that, and Suzanne.
To save our petrol, we all know you've got to take a train, or else you've got to drive it slow and keep the car to run just so. Now there's at least a dozen ways that you can drive real neat, so I've just got to look after my escape machine. Freeway, drive up the clean way with Amoco in my machine.
With Amoco in my machine.
She's running like a dream. She's buying up, building clean. Amoco saves my machine.
With Amoco in my machine.
I'm taking the freeway, driving the clean way with Amoco in my machine.
With Amoco in my machine.
She's running like a dream. She's buying up, building clean. Amoco saves my machine.
With Amoco in my machine.
I'm taking the freeway, driving.
Righto. Where's Pinky gone?
I don't know.
I'm here.
Yep.
Oh, excuse me, I just farted.
Thank you.
Excuse me, I just farted. I'm sorry, Graham. I think I ate too many worms for lunch.
Do you remember that taekwondo expert we had on the Channel 9ers?
I sure do.
He broke this board. What did I say? You didn't mean to say that, did you?
The purge of Argentina's military junta has started following Tuesday's humiliating surrender in the Falklands. President Leopoldo Galtieri has been forced to step down because no one could pronounce his name.
A pin bouncing off a balloon, you say?
Couldn't happen.
Well, it can happen if the pin comes at a very shallow angle towards the surface of the balloon. Let's have a look at this. I'll push with a reasonable force. and you can hear what's happening. It's not penetrating, it's actually bouncing off the surface. What happens, though, if the pin comes directly down from above with the same force? Is that a rotten thing?
We could work it out whenever there was any doubt.
You got two lungs, too. Two testes, two lungs. One dick. Now, who asked that question?
At the moment, we're working with Marsha Hines. We're doing
a
double act, and we're also singing. So I don't know why I said that.
Well, I hope before you do it, you'll come on with Marsha and do a number.
That'd be great.
Song.
Yep, yes, and we'll sing as well.
Good to see you, John. Good to see you, John. John English, ladies and gentlemen.
I don't believe that. Let's see if we can take out that bottom coin by hitting it with the back of a knife. Well, a cardboard box is a very good structure for absorbing energy. In fact, if I take a heavy weight like this, I can drop that on the cardboard box and let's see what happens. How do you tell what the weather's going to be like tomorrow? Well, you look at the weather forecast in the paper, television or radio. You don't look at it in the radio, what am I talking about?
She had to stop hating herself before she could learn to love again. Mary Tyler Moore, a stunning performance in First You Cry. Nine's four-star movie, Sunday, 8:30, and it's all bloody well run out.
Join IRS Irrigation and Channel 9 for a great season of... That's good. That's okay, I got off on the left foot too.
Yeah, Yaddy, it's the mid-dawn spin. And here to help me spin tonight is Yvette from the Owl's Nest, bus stop 21, Port Road, Woodville. And the bird's name is right. And number 21, no, why did it take number 28? 28 you want... Here we go, we're going to spin. Where's 28? I've got to find the darn thing first.
Kiyomo and Calendar on this side.
that Bob Randall changed all that. The 32-year-old telecom technician capitalized on the backlash. Morning.
I said, I'm here,
having pictures. Oh, I see, right. By all means. Yeah.
On the old television.
Trying to feed the seagulls, but they don't seem to want any this morning. I don't know why. They must get more than they need, I think.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. He's found a little bit, anyway.
Yeah, he got a bit.
In the changing rooms behind me, John's already started his session with the ruckman. Tonight it's just a pep talk, and it's... And they've been working solid since Saturday's loss against St Kilda. He's having a good look. Oh. He's going to have a look at everyone before he sets out his plans. In the changing rooms behind me, John's already started his session with the boys. Right, keep it going. At 6 a.m. this morning, they were up training hard at... In the changing rooms behind me, John's already started his talk with the Ruth... In the changing room behind me, the... You'll remember the last two times, it was with North Melbourne to give him a hand. It's the first of six sessions he'll have with the Demons. Okay, keep going. But whatever the outcome... And if anybody's hopeful that... Alan Collegia for Eyewitness Sport.
No, because they've got mainly walking in soil and they've got rocks to scratch on, trees to scrape their toes on. And we haven't even any walls.
Dave, you were telling me they sweat through their feet, don't they? Whereabouts?
They sweat all around the top.
Yes.
And in between the toes, mainly between the toes.
Wow. Right, right. And, of course, you have to paint in here as well to kind of look after... That's actually the quick, isn't it?
We're being flooded out of the... That's the quick there. It's very thin, as you can see. If I... See how she flinched then?
Golly, all right. So you'll have to do... She'll have to get used to this idea of having her feet done now. How often are you going to be doing this from here on in?
Oh, about once a month.
I love those discreet phrases they use. Richard Burton was tired and emotional after a meal.
Can you imagine?
In Australia, you call it pissed, but overseas, it's tired and emotional.
Sit! 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 Stay!
Something showing up with the vectorscope.
Where?
15 degrees from vector red. Straight ahead.
I see it. Prepare for battle stations.
I'm ready.
Let's go.
We should be within firing range, John. Switch on the targeting computer.
Switched on, Bob.
Let's get the bastards.
Okay.
News here on 7. I mean, where else are you going to fucking find it? On 9? Current city temperature, 19 degrees. Well, that's the news this moment. I'll be back at 6:30 and again at 10:30 tomorrow night with the next major editions of 7 National News. In the meantime, don't forget 11 a.m. for the first news of the day, 7 o'clock tomorrow. On 7 tomorrow at 11 a.m. Hope you understand that. See you tomorrow night. Good night.
Many people are becoming concerned at the increasing incidence of hit-run drivers. Here's a case in point, and you may well ask what goes through a sparrow's mind when he hits the grill of a car at 100 miles an hour. The answer is, his fucking ass.
That's how we saw the news today, Saturday, the 30th of October. Mal will be back at 6 o'clock tomorrow evening with the next edition of 7 National News. Before I say goodnight, don't forget, put the clocks back and watches back 1 hour. before you go to bed tonight. And in fact, don't put them back 1 hour, put them forward 1 hour. That's how confused I am about daylight saving. Forward 1 hour. From the news team, pleasant viewing, good luck with the watch changing and good night.
And just before we go, a story just to hand. For more details, we crossed news. And just before we go, story just I can't do it.
Well, across the state today, the weather was cloudy with isolated showers in southern and mountain districts. Snow fell also here on the northeast ranges, with the highest temperature today of 19 degrees recorded here at Orbost, and here in Melbourne, the temperature reached 17.1 degrees. That's all I have for you right now. I hope you'll have a good week. And Mel, now it's over to you.
Thank you very much, Debbie. I think we had a somewhat slight depression here too. Well, we managed to get over that. A few little technical difficulties. Thanks for bearing with us. That's all for tonight's edition of 7 National News. I'll be back tomorrow night at 6:30. Until then, take care. Good night.
Voice call 555.
I've got to find a phone box.
Oh, not again.
There's got to be an easier way.
There is. Now, JTEL, the makers of Meter Beater, introduce new video voice call pocket pager. No waste of time finding a phone box. Our computer-controlled, digitally multiplexed EEPROM program with analog subcircuitry gives you your answers direct. Call now on 443 361 875.
This is JTEL Video Call, the unobtrusive way to instant communications.
Video call 555. Please call 263701.
Oh, not again.
I've still got to find a phone.
JTEL video call for people on the move who need instant hands-free communication.
Have you ever wanted a facelift but never thought you could afford it? Well, now you can with the new Barmy Home Facelifter. Hundreds of finely sharpened stainless steel blades spinning at 3,000 revs per minute. Quickly and painfully remove excess facial fat, stimulating raw tissue to give you a new, fresh appearance. The Barmy Home Facelifter makes an ideal gift and is suitable as a toy for toddlers.
Pimples, you bet. I've tried everything, but nothing seems to work.
We challenged Warwick to the Big Zit 5-day test.
What makes Big Zit any different?
Because Big Zit not only starts pimples on top, but penetrates deep below to quickly breed acne bacteria, helping to generate and spread acne pimples. It starts the acne cycle. 5 days later, Warwick, how's the pimples?
Lot better, thanks. Big Zit really works.
Try the Big Zit 5-day test yourself and you too could restore youthful looks in just 5 days. And now available in the big squeeze pack too.
Now, from the producers of Debbie Does Dallas, Debbie Does New York, and Debbie Does the entire eastern seaboard of continental USA, comes the greatest child pornography film of all time. See new exciting acts of erotic pleasure as you join Mrs. Marsh and her neonatal nymphos. Mrs. Marsh demonstrates hundreds of new sex positions to her young sex fiends.
Ooh, it does get in.
And while it's penetrating,
See new erotic uses for chalk. See acts of oral sex. See what turns these young sex fiends on.
Chunny and hard.
Find out all about the new contraceptives that stops you fooling around.
Fooling on.
Mrs. Marsh and her neonatal nymphos now available on VHS or Beta Video Cassette.
Soundtrack copies of the heavy breathing bits are also available on audio file half-speed master LPs.
Hi, I'm Richard Maggot Muncher and I represent CMX Systems, a division of RX Corporation, Santa Clara Boulevard, Los Angeles, California. And I'm here to demonstrate this revolutionary breakthrough by CMX Systems in software and hardware development and the new options offered to clients in the field of post-production. The heart of this new accessory is the C-Square, or Client Control Interface. This interfaces the CMX computer with the client, and using the new operating program version 999, allows the editor instant fingertip control over any situation. The C-Square is unlike the other interfaces here in that it is not an intelligent interface. It does not have to be, as any editor will tell you, most clients aren't very intelligent anyway. It is rack mountable, runs on 240 volts, and is AC-DC. This does not mean that it works on batteries, it simply means that it works equally well on bisexual clients. plant control is accessed by hitting the control C keys simultaneously together and at the same time. The system then asks plant control. Answer yes by hitting the Y key or the Enter key. The system then displays the client control options you may use. 1. Physical abuse. 2. Mental abuse. 3. Sexual abuse. 4. Electrical shock. 5. Subliminal electromolecular particle deceleration. 6. All of the above. 7. Delete client. If 7 is selected, the system then asks, delete client. Hit A for all. The system then confirms by asking again, delete clients all, as a safety measure, because once a client has been deleted, he doesn't come back. In the recreated situation, we will now show you, the editor has just completed a very difficult commercial and is about to dub it to cassette, but the client has changed his mind as usual. Here he uses client control to solve the situation. Client control does not adjust the commercial to suit the client, but adjusts the client to suit the commercial.
Okay, completed that last edit. Would you like a cassette dub?
Now, I'm a bit worried about the edit earlier in.
Which one?
The second shot in.
You mean the one with the two keys and the live camera zoom with the chroma key graphic and the split screen effect?
Yeah, that's the one. I think we should wipe the zooming graphic on.
Well, the cameraman's gone home.
Can't you do it? You're the editor. You can do anything.
Well, I have to stay here and follow the graphic with the split screen.
Can't you put it on tape?
No, I'm sorry. We're using all the machines with that master slave effect that you wanted.
Well, I don't care how long it takes. I've still got 15 minutes of my booking left. Just do it.
Okay, I'll see what I can do.
What seems to be the hold-up?
Well, I'm finding the edit in the list.
The editor now decides that the time is right to use client control. He selects client control mode by hitting the Control C keys simultaneously. The screen then displays the client control options, and he selects option 6, which includes all the abuses. The system then indicates it is in client control mode, and the client is completely unaware of what is about to happen.
Thank you, that's terrific.
As you have seen, client control is very effective in handling even the most difficult to please agency representatives. We here at CMX Systems are most confident client control will be an invaluable supplement to your existing or future CMX post-production facility. Should you have any further inquiries, please do not hesitate to write us or telephone toll-free the number on your screen. Thank you for your time.
Awful colours, this warper mule. Look at him, Wally.
Yeah, well, get off your ass and give us a bit of a hand.
Up you.
Yeah. I said cream.
Well, if you don't like it, get off your jacksie and come over here and do it yourself.
Stupid bit.
Warper mule, it's a real shit of a paint.
Fair dickum, she's studying to be an idiot.
Shut up, you hairy little bastard. Settle for less. Falcon is the answer.
You're watching World of Sport on TVT.
Gets a good, strong, powerful run.
.30 tonight is the time for Benson this week, and when Pete gives Benson some stock to pay off a debt, Clayton and Krause mistakenly invest, thinking it's valuable. Family follows at 8, and the Lawrence household is upended when Kate thinks it's colour bars.
Dunlop Steel Max. When lives depend on superb handling and road-grabbing stopping power, trust Dunlop Steel Max.
Dunlop, number one in tyre technology.
The National Press Club in Canberra has reported a generally successful year of luncheons. The spokesman said, however, there have been a number of unfortunate incidents.
Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen.
It's been an eventful year in the Capital 7 production department with a mixture of trials and triumphs. An example of the latter was this outside broadcast.
Tonight's gala evening of indoor show jumping is a first for Australia, although similar European events have attracted viewers of almost 20 million. A top international lineup of riders from Australia, West Germany, Japan, Canada, America, and everybody else who's running around.
That's this year's Australian Capital Blues. From all of us, good night.
If you had any talent, you'd be able to edit it out anyway.
The best of comments by Barbara Bowers.
Good evening.
I hop on both legs, not one like you. I'm Hoppity Hop the Kangaroo.
Lost control. It's shame to see that a tech like me records so many bad edits. I'm off the rails. My M-Tech fails. Clary's got hold of me. And I can't record. Oh, help. Can't help myself, bad edits. Well, it's just a blight, but it's something I can't fight. My problem is so big, I just can't skirt. I tried to assemble great, but I realized all too late, the button that is glowing says insert. I'm just a dirge without an urge. I'm a slave to all my time code. Well, I'm in a mess and two's gone into test. Oh, all of these bad edits. Bad edits. Oh, and help myself. Bad edits.
And superstar Del Shannon, all on country. Oh, shit and bloody disaster. Hatred, loathing, detestation, Nazism, communism, bronchitis.
Oh, it's stopped altogether now. Well, just keep going. Now, well, I'm pressing 79. I'll just press it once more. 79. All right, then. Well, we've got a 79, a 78, and a 77. What's that?
The delicious taste of Quick.
On the synoptic chart, we can see the reason for the coming settled weather. A very strong high-pressure system here
to the west, 1,035 millibars centered in the Bight. A ridge coming up the coast here with the winds mostly southwesterlies along to the south, but turning southeast and even northeast along the coast. Generally speaking, dry, settled conditions are likely, and the next front is way over here in the southwest. Back to Tim.
No, it's me. Well, thank you, David.
Chicks to drool. You wanna have a ball?
You know, darling, what could be better than this? A nice, quiet evening at home.
A roaring fire.
Beethoven playing in the background.
A nice Chinese in the oven.
And boxing on the television. I know.
And I know.
And now, here's the star of our show, Mike Waltz.
Hello. Right, we have Nick Gazzano with us today, and this is a song that won a Grammy Award. It's a mighty good song. It's called I'm So Glad I'm Standing Here Today. Nick Gazzano, ladies and gentlemen.
There were times I remember had to fight just to keep my head up. Those times when even my friends tried to make a fool of me, there were things that my heart knew.
Sorry about the sound, that we had a problem. I think in all the years we're doing the show live, it's never happened before, so it had to happen one day. Sorry about that. We'll take a break and be back in a moment.
So let's get things moving with Buck Spears, My Camera Never Lies.
8 on 7 National News are sophisticated. Pretty sophisticated. It's not sophisticated at all. This must be a release of tension. Be better off wanking, I think. For interstate travellers, tomorrow Sydney is expecting a windy day. Windy also in Canberra. A few showers in Melbourne. Adelaide will be fine. There'll be a cool morning change in Hobart. And it'll be fine in Perth. Now the Ipswich and Toowoomba forecast. I think we just dropped the camera over there. It'll be fine in Ipswich tomorrow with a top temperature predicted tomorrow of 26 degrees. The Garden City can expect fine weather. That's the funniest thing I've seen in the studio for a long while. Oh, boy. The Garden City can expect fine weather with light to moderate. I'll tell you what we're going to do. Just take a break while I compose myself. Are you all right? Stay with us. We'll be back with our cameraman, who now has flat toes, in just a moment.
And a very warm 28 tomorrow. Fishing, Bob Jansen.
Thanks, Fran. And of course, if you're heading for the South Coast, take lots of suntan lotion, because there's not much happening down there.
Try the taste of VTT, the most beautiful drink in the world. It's the right one. It's the bright one. It's VTT.
Anytime, any place, anywhere. There's a wonderful world you can share in the bright one. The right one, that's VTT.
I bet by now he's well on his way up into the cockpit.
Okay, thank you very much, Gene. As always, it's been a pleasure working with you. We've had, of course, another major story to deal with today. Not only the shuttle here, but a major story, as we say, the passing, the announcement of the passing of Leonid Brezhnev, the man who has ruled the Soviet Union since 1964. So we're going to bring you up to date on that now, and we go back to Washington and Kathleen Sullivan and Charles Gibson. I wanted to go to David, but they kept saying. Well, he was here. Why didn't somebody? You were told he wasn't there.
I succeed the Soviet leader. The announcement of his death came 26 hours after the Soviet president had died. He died approximately noon Eastern time yesterday. However, the announcement was made to the Soviet people late last night.
It's not, it's his first shuttle launch. That's he saw some Apollos, but he's not seen a shuttle. He was here for the STS-2 when we went to 31 seconds and scrubbed, and then he couldn't come back.
I knew he was here.
Know what life's going to be like when you make the decision to go for the top. But aren't there times when you would long for the less complicated life?
Oh, sure. But you can't let that get on top of you.
What does get on top of you?
But, Malcolm.
It was like somebody giving a lift to a known rapist, dropping him off outside a nurse's home, and then saying when rape occurs, it's not my problem. That at least is how most of the world saw Israel's actions in regard to the Beirut massacres. Israel, of course, has now finally agreed to some sort of inquiry. Turn there, sorry. It's not my problem.
I'm Jana Vint.
I'm Ray Martin.
I'm Ian Leslie.
And I'm George Negus.
Fuck me dead tonight on 60 Minutes.
When the Poms told me they were changing their airline and wanted me to check it out, I told them they couldn't afford my fee. But the suckers came through. Of course, the bloody beer was warm. And the movie looked as if it had been directed by Cecil B. DeMille's granddad. Even their holiday brochure wouldn't cover a Poms hard-on. In club class, it wasn't much better. Not many customers either. I felt as if I was sat next to the invisible man. To keep myself entertained, I calculated how much they were losing on the flight. It wasn't until I was in first class and could stretch out and relax that I came to the conclusion that the Poms just might take off in the Pacific. If only they could buy a fuselage and wings.
Speaking of boyfriends, Mandy, I wish your date was great.
Good night.
Good night.